Today's podcast is brought to you by Audible. Get a free audiobook download and a 30-day free trial at audibletrial.com/CheapGeek. Over 180,000 titles to choose from your iPhone, Android, Kindle, MP3 player, Sony Walkman. They got it all. So welcome to CheapGeek Podcast. This is episode number 42.
Rob Lowe Spots Bigfoot, Amelia Earhart, Prime Day, and Our Mountains Are on Fire. Again.
So it begins again. This is episode number 42.
Yes.
So my computer just turned off.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Well, that's unfortunate.
It angers me.
I know.
It's like wake up. Wake up, you piece of technology.
Technology. Well, while you're doing that, I do want to remind everybody.
Fixed it.
Okay.
No, go ahead.
Well, I do want to remind everybody you can call the show and leave us a message. You can call us at 575-208-4025. We are running a contest still for a sticker and a small prize pack for the Cheap Geek Podcast. We're going to wrap that up probably in the next 2 weeks. And if you haven't participated, all you have to do is call the show and leave us a message and like us on Facebook. That's all you got to do.
Yeah.
And so far,
one guy's winning.
We got one guy in the lead.
And you know who you are.
Yeah.
Whatever your name is.
Shh.
I don't want to give it away.
I know, right? It's a surprise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So here we go. Episode number 42.
Yes.
So we've been doing this for what? 4 or 5 years now?
Sometimes. Feels like it, yes.
Yeah.
Well, that's why podcasts and like radio shows try to start off with episode 101. It's like,
because they're lying to you. They're
yeah.
Like, we've been doing this for a long time.
No, you haven't.
Cheaters.
You know, like English 101.
Well, we've been doing this long enough to where we're on iHeartRadio, we're on iTunes, Google Play Store, Play Music, whatever that is. What else? The website you can get us at. Facebook you can listen
Libsyn
to us at.
Feed.
Libsyn, you can get us there.
Yep.
What's the other one? SoundCloud, you can get us there.
Yeah.
All over the place. So, yeah. YouTube's, if you just want to kind of like start it and then you can listen and then click away and look at other stuff,
mm-hmm.
You can do that.
I do that. I'll like do chores around the house or fold laundry and just let it play on YouTube. So.
That's not true.
Yeah, it is. So. Anyways.
Yeah. So basically what it boils down to is we're here in New Mexico. This is where we do our podcast from.
Yep. Yeah.
And we've been doing this for a while, and if you're tuning in for the very first time, thank you very much for tuning in. You probably found us by accident. That's okay. We welcome you with open arms,
yep.
Like a little Tyrannosaurus Rex with little short arms, which means it's going to be a close hug. Yeah,
I'm not
bring it in. I'm not a close talker, so you don't have to worry about that.
Oh.
But yeah, we've been doing this for a little while, and then we find stuff that we think is interesting.
Yeah.
We put it out there.
Yes, we do.
And we hope that you think it's interesting, too. And if you don't, well... But it's free.
Yeah.
So suck it up. Listen anyway.
But
leave a comment.
So we've been here in New Mexico, just outside Albuquerque, for almost like 2 years-ish or so.
Yeah.
And the one thing is, if you haven't been to New Mexico and you haven't been to the Southwest, when you see photos, like little pretty photos of Albuquerque, and you see those mountains in the background, they're not like in the far background. They're literally right there in the city of Albuquerque, and they're called the Sandia Mountains. And apparently Sandia means like watermelon. And they're really pretty mountains. It's a real nice chance to go straight from the city to really rugged, beautiful outdoor recreation area. Well, they're on fire. The top is on fire, I should say. Yes. The Sandia Crest caught on fire, I want to say, when was it? Late Sunday night? Monday?
July 8th.
Oh, July 8th.
That's
really?
When that started.
Yeah. And it started with a little little cleared out area, and you could see by mid-afternoon, you could see a little black plume of straight smoke coming from the top of the mountain.
Yeah.
And what's really critical is the fact that the area that this fire is occurring is right next to major communication towers for Albuquerque.
Yeah.
Yeah. So all the cell phone towers and radio towers and stuff like that, that's where this fire is occurring, which is messed up because last November, somebody actually tried to set fire to those towers.
Yep.
So they're on fire again.
Yep.
And then the south.
Well, I mean, there's a good part of our area has been on fire at one time or the other.
I know. This whole, like, past 30 days, we have had multiple.
As a matter of fact, before we even started the podcast, there's another fire.
Yep.
They caught on fire. We have fire that's catching fire on fire.
That's true.
So there's fire every day. And it's cloudy. Everybody's like hazy. Yeah. It's messing up my sinuses.
And the area that's on fire, it's not far from the entire
sinuses.
Area that was on fire last year.
Yep.
So nonstop fires.
Yeah. And, you know, basically they're closing trails up on the Sandias and stuff like that. And hikers are disappointed.
They closed the Crest Road. So you can't even drive up. Like, if you're a tourist here in the city right now.
Yeah.
Unfortunately for you, you can't drive up to the mountain and take those pretty little, you know, City of Albuquerque shots.
Yep. You'll just have to pay the price and take the tram thing up.
Well, if the employees. Well,
just check. Just check.
Yeah. If the employees can't get up to the tram. So.
Well, look. Yeah. Stop. Just stop smashing the tourist bubble, okay?
It's just
they do have a suspect.
Oh, they do?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lightning.
Oh, for this one?
Yeah.
I know Lightning is
Is currently the suspected cause for the fire.
For this one or the Edgewood one?
I don't know.
Okay. Cuz this one was looking suspicious. I don't know. So the
Long I think this is the one we were talking about today, the 1D Edgewood fire.
Yeah,
I
that
think
one
is,
should be
is Lightning. Is what they're saying.
Yeah. Oh, so all the trails, all the really cool trails are closed, but the super hard trail, I'm reading the bottom of the article, the Pedro Lisa South Trail, that one's still open. Okay. So if you're that much of a badass, you can
Nobody
still
knows
hike.
Where we're talking about.
Well, yeah. A lot of the outdoorsy people do.
Who?
But, you know, like, you know, professional.
We have professionals now?
Actually, there are like serious outdoor enthusiasts.
Let's think about this. That actually listen to our podcast.
Well, I doubt they listen, but still. Oh,
how dare you?
You know what?
Anyway, all we're trying to say is stuff's on fire.
Again.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's and, like, well, what's,
I think this is a thing that happens every year.
What's silly is all this stuff is on fire. We have all these restrictions regarding fireworks. And what did we hear last night?
Fireworks.
On our street. Like, yeah. Big,
okay,
serious
ones. You know, that's a little bit of a rant for me. Yeah. You know, it's done. 4th of July is over with. Stop blowing shit up. Seriously.
Yeah.
And why are you waiting till like midnight to blow stuff up?
Yeah.
It's probably because you don't want nobody to catch you blowing stuff up because you're supposed to be done.
Yeah.
So stop it. Nobody cares. Just quit. Put it away before you hurt yourself.
Yeah.
Or set something on fire.
They actually woke me up last night. And by wake me up, I mean it woke the dogs up. The dogs got terrified and they woke me up. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, not cool.
Stop blowing stuff up.
Yeah.
You know, get back to adulting.
True. So, quit setting stuff on fire.
Yeah. Okay, so are you ready?
Okay. For what?
Amazon Prime Day.
Definitely.
So, Amazon Prime Day happens every year now. It's like a new thing. It's kind of like Black Friday for Amazon, but it happens in July. Usually in and around my birthday, which is kind of weird, but that's okay. I don't think there's a correspondence with that.
Yep.
I don't know if that really worked or not. But anyway, here's the deal with Amazon Prime. There's a lot of people out there that say, well, I don't really use Amazon, so I don't really care. Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of people out there that say, well, I'm not really Amazon Prime because I don't think I would spend enough or buy enough stuff to be worth the spending the money for the Amazon Prime.
And it's a whole $99.
Yeah, which is a lot of money.
Yeah.
You know, especially if you think you're not going to use it. And that's where the problem lies. If you spent the money and you start looking at Amazon, then you will try to do your best to get your $99 worth, and you will.
Yeah.
And that's how they get you. Because once they get you in there, next thing you know, you auto-renew, you forget all about it, and you just get stuff from Amazon all the time.
Yeah.
Now, the cool thing about this Prime Day, lots of deals, lots of specials and stuff like that, if you know where to look. But even Amazon says, hey, use our free trial. If you like it, stay with it. If you don't like it, then don't. You can unsubscribe. You can cancel the trial.
And they're actually doing it.
So they're promoting, like, hey,
yeah,
you can rip us off for Amazon Prime Day. It's cool.
Yeah.
If you don't like it, you can cancel, which is I thought was kind of cool. It was like, okay.
Not only can you rip us off, but we're offering all sorts of $3 free trial bounties, which, you know, if you're into Amazon Prime, it's a reward. And they're starting it off in 1 hour from us recording this podcast.
Well, nobody knows when we record this podcast. Prime Day starts the 11th of July.
Well, technically it starts
It starts the 11th of July. What are you doing? Why are you arguing with me about everything that I say, woman? I know what it says on the internets, but that's not when this is going live. This may go live a month from now. We don't even know.
Okay.
What happens if the fire gets over here and kills us from being able to broadcast? Yeah. As far as kills the technology. Because we'll be long gone by the time something like that gets here. With all these people blowing up fireworks, it's only a matter of time. Being as it's all dry and all. So. What?
There are a lot of websites that are already posting the best deals that you can find available on Amazon Prime. The Verge actually is doing a little countdown. So things like Sony headphones. Well, the Verge
headphones. They're run by communists.
Great. An unlocked Samsung Galaxy S8 bundle. That's pretty good.
You can't say it's pretty good without getting a price. That's how this goes. What's the price?
$624.99.
What? Mm-hmm. $624?
Yep.
Well, that's a bargain.
Well, compared to it being $900.
Yeah, I'm not doing that anymore. I'm not buying really expensive phones anymore because there's really nothing that's worth me wanting to spend that extra money on.
Okay.
You know, the whole flagship phone thing?
Mm-hmm.
Not doing it. Not anymore. They do have deals, though, if you're a Prime member, on some phones that you could use, like the, what do you call them? You know, the phones that you can use anywhere, unlocked phones.
Yeah.
You can get like the Motorola phone, like the G5 Plus for under $300. They have LG phones. They have all sorts of phones. They have all sorts of deals. Here's the deal with Amazon Prime Day. You got to have a little bit of a plan. You got to know what people are looking for, what people want to buy. So that in turn kind of determines what's going to be for sale. So most companies that have their listings on Amazon right now are reducing the prices of what they currently have to try to compete with Amazon Prime just to try to get your business. Right?
Yeah.
Which is very nice. Now, on top of all that, you have to kind of take a look at what's been the recent and best sellers on Amazon Prime. And since I look at Amazon every day, I've kind of found a little bit of a trend that things like drones are going to be on sale and heavily marked down, dash cams for your car, anything that Amazon makes is going to be pretty, hopefully, heavily discounted. You know, like the Echo and their tablets, like the Amazon Fire tablets, those are going to be marked down. And there'll be some other stuff, too. Piece of advice, though, as we kind of said this before in a previous podcast, don't buy stuff that's going to go on sale again, like back-to-school stuff. You want to save that for later. So you're kind of looking at technology-related stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
So there you go. That's all I got to say about that. What are you going to buy?
I'm not sure yet. I'm torn between some hiking gear or some sandals, actually.
Well, what do you mean by hiking gear? What kind of hiking gear?
This is actually a great time to get out-of-season hiking gear on sale. So if you want things like winter hiking boots or the heavier backpacks, since most of the through hiking is already up for the season, you can find those larger capacity or larger volume hiking packs for pretty cheap because they've already become last year's model. Yeah. So if you pay attention to things like hiking trends and things like that, you can also pick up last season's hiking shoes for a decent price too.
Yep. See, that's what I'm talking about.
Yep.
Well, okay. That's pretty exciting.
Mm-hmm.
All right. There is one thing that you need.
What?
It is the Furbo dog camera. Do you know what I'm talking about?
No.
What it is it's this little camera. It's like a webcam. Right? You fill it full of dog treats, and then you can talk to your dog, and when your dog basically interacts with you, you can tell the Furbo to spit out a little dog treat.
That thing is $169.
I know. Got to pay to play. Right? It's a treat-tossing HD Wi-Fi camera with two-way audio. That way you can talk to your dog, and your dog can talk back.
You know, you could also get the Pet Cube Play 180 or 1080p for
$154. Hmm.
Yep.
Maybe.
Oh, $149.
Yeah, there's lots of deals, yep. Lots of sales. So by the time you listen to this, hopefully you will have had a chance to partake into the Amazon Prime Day.
Okay.
And they have all sorts of Prime Day specials. So things like earbuds, wireless things are going to be on sale. The Fire 7 tablet from Amazon. The Echo Dot, if you're looking for something like that, it's going to be about $35. It's going to be some good stuff in there. So do your shopping. Do wisely.
Okay.
Yep. That's all I got to say about that.
So, this was news to me.
What?
And I didn't know how to take it at first. We all know it's, you know, there's the paranormal and then there's mainstream celebrity type news. Those are two separate entities. And it's kind of interesting when they interact or, you know, cross worlds. And this just came out this week. Rob Lowe claims to have spotted Bigfoot during filming of new show. And this caught me off guard because when you think of celebrities seeing weird stuff in the woods, you think, you know, maybe like Les Stroud or what's-his-face from Bear Grylls or something like that. Not Rob Lowe, the celebrity.
Which one drinks his own urine?
That would be Bear Grylls.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yes. Les Stroud's the man. So, yeah.
He does not drink his own urine.
No, he does not.
He has never put himself in a position where he needs to survive by drinking his own pee-pee. So if I'm going to listen to anybody, it's probably going to be him.
So apparently, the actor told Entertainment Weekly that he came across the mysterious creature while filming his new A&E series, The Lowe Files. Yes.
Hold on, what?
The docu-series follows Rob Lowe and his two sons as they explore the Ozark Mountains, which stretch between Arkansas, Missouri, and Oklahoma, in search of the wood ape.
So hold on.
Yeah.
Basically,
yes,
he's claiming to have spotted Bigfoot while filming a Bigfoot show.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I know, right? Hmm. I'm like, since when was Rob Lowe a Bigfoot enthusiast?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now I feel like we kind of need to get A&E so just so I can see this. I mean, is he serious? Is he melodramatic like he is on certain shows?
Well, what he said was...
Yeah.
Right?
Because
he and his son went camping on basically to film the scene, I guess.
Uh-huh.
And the scene is in the season finale of the Lowe Files. Lowe said that they encountered a real live wood ape. Right?
Yeah.
We had an incredible encounter with what the locals call the wood ape, which is in the Ozark Mountains, he claimed. I'm fully aware that I sound like a crazy Hollywood kook right now. And he said it was terrifying.
Yeah.
I was lying on the ground thinking I was going to be killed.
Oh, God.
So,
He
also said he believes in ghosts. He says, nothing is staged, nothing is trick cut, no BS. I believe that there are probably ghosts out there. Out there. And the Lowe Files premieres on August 2nd. So we'll have to wait until the 2nd of August.
Well, I kind of want
to
see
it. If Lowe really is a Hollywood kook.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's kind of weird.
But... I mean, it's a celebrity. Did somebody go out there, hide, and dress up in a Sasquatch costume?
I don't know.
That's my thing.
Hmm.
So, I don't know.
What if this is real? What if you really encountered something?
Which is weird, because there's been other docu-series that go for seasons now and still haven't seen them.
Well, yeah, that's why I stopped watching the Finding Bigfoot thing.
Yeah. I mean, what season were they on?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I stopped watching. Because they never found anything.
I don't know. I didn't think of Rob Lowe as somebody who would be looking for Bigfoot.
Me either.
Yeah. So
it is kind of weird.
Yeah.
So something to think about. So if you happen to, if you really like Rob Lowe, go ahead and put it on your Google calendar. Then on August 2nd, you can kind of go through and start watching the Lowe Files.
Yeah.
And then hopefully by the time you get to the end of the season, you can figure out if Rob Lowe actually seen a wood ape or not.
Or his fantastic hair.
Yeah, or you can think he's a Hollywood kook. Really, the choice is yours. I just thought that was kind of weird and kind of just like, what?
Yeah.
And I also seen this, which I thought was also kind of weird and kind of like, what? You know what it is?
What?
excuse me, I got a little forest fire in my throat.
Mm-hmm.
This was an article that I read that I thought was, it kind of caught my attention. I'm like, what? And it kind of goes like this. NASA politely clarifies that it is not running a child slave colony on Mars.
What the?
I didn't even know this was a concern, but evidently it is. So they had to clarify, hey, look, we're not running a child slave colony on Mars.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's, oh my goodness. How would you even come up with that rumor?
Well, you have to ask Alec Jones.
Of course.
Good old Alex, right?
Of course it comes back to Alex Jones.
He's a conspiracy theory-loving radio host.
Yes.
And he apologized for spreading the fake news about a child sex ring.
Oh, Pizzagate.
And, yeah, I don't know what the deal
was with
that.
He never truly apologized. Yeah. This article links back to that interview he had with that lady, and it's been proven that it was cut up.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So that's what that paragraph's about. But they're, you know, they are giving him notoriety for that whole Pizzagate incident. But now he's claiming, you know, not only is there a child slavery sex ring in Washington, D.C., but now there's a child slave colony on the planet Mars.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, just to make sure this conspiracy theory doesn't catch fire and take over the internets, NASA is getting ahead of themselves and being forced to deny it right off the bat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're saying that the colony is populated by children who were kidnapped and sent into space on a 20-year ride. So once they get to Mars, they have no alternative but to be slaves on the Mars colony.
That's like that other...
they also claim,
theory.
Right?
Yeah.
That the Mars abductees were also being killed for their blood and bone marrow.
Okay.
Yeah, so when I was reading all this, I'm like, this is crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that goes into that other theory that was going on during Obama's second election, that he was a Mars child and him and like half these famous people were abductees and living on some space colony.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but this is ridiculous.
Yeah, and it kind of goes, because this whole thing started, there was like a Wikipedia article or a Wikipedia entry for this person that Alex Jones interviewed named Robert David Steele.
Yeah.
Who lists him, he says he's an American activist, former CIA, clandestine services case officer, and evidently he is laying this all out there.
So Jones decided to interview him and give him a soapbox?
Yeah.
Great.
Well,
okay.
Of course, why not? And basically, Steele claims that 90% of NASA's missions are secret and that most people have no idea what's really happening. But the quote is, but I know this. We see a bunch of mechanical wreckage on Mars and people say, oh, look at that. It looks like mechanics. And they go, oh, yeah, you're a conspiracy theorist. And clearly they don't want us to look into what's happening. So every time the probes go over that spot, they turn it off. Yeah, so I'm like, I don't know. But anyway, there's a link to it in our show notes if you want to go ahead and drop down this rabbit hole and read some really crazy stuff.
That's just beyond crazy. I mean, when do people realize that they sound absurd? Never?
No, because that just steals them to make even more claims because they're like, well, they don't believe me. So, yeah, it's...
That's really sad.
Yeah.
I mean...
But I'm glad NASA went ahead and clarified that.
And how can you have secret NASA missions, at least in the United States? I mean, almost all the bases are heavily monitored. All the places that you could take off a giant spacecraft are mostly monitored. I mean, people would report sightings, you know?
Maybe they are. I mean, you have to report them to the government. And what if the government's in on it? Then they're like, nope.
Well, then people would do what they do here in New Mexico and go straight to the local news, you know? Or I'd go straight to YouTube if I had footage like that, you know?
Yeah, at which point we wouldn't believe you either. And then we'd say, this person's crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I don't know. I kind of read that. I thought that was kind of weird. And we're starting to have some thunderstorms, which is kind of cool, which is kind of nice. Maybe it'll rain really hard. Maybe it'll put out some of the fires we got going on. That'll be kind of neat.
Oh, wow. That was a good one.
I wonder if people can hear that.
I doubt it.
Can you hear the thunder?
Yeah.
Can you hear the thunder and the lightning?
It's okay, dogs.
Can you hear the rain? The dogs are like, whoa.
Yeah.
Ben, our big dog, has already decided to go ahead and...
seek shelter.
Take safe refuge in the bathtub.
Yes.
So he's in there right now.
Because that's the safest place during a thunderstorm or any natural disaster.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of these terrible things that were happening, right? And NASA had to clarify... Just to kind of make sure that, you know, United doesn't go untouched for all the stuff that they've been having. I read this and I was like, you got to be kidding me. I didn't hear anything about this, right?
Yeah.
So United Airlines, right, they have to apologize. And they did apologize after giving away a toddler's purchased seat on flight to Boston.
Now, that's what really struck me, is that I didn't realize their policy was so young.
Yep.
You know, various airlines have different policies, but United, if the child is over the age of 2, you're required to purchase them a seat.
Yep.
I didn't realize that. I thought, you know, as long as the general policy was that if they were big enough to not sit in a car seat, you had to buy them a seat.
Nope. According to them, you got to buy them a seat. And so the passenger's name was Shirley Yamamuchi. And she paid almost $1,000 each for 2 tickets, right? Because children over the age of 2 are required to have their own seat.
That's crazy.
So she boarded a Boston-bound plane in Houston because she's from Hawaii with her son.
Mm-hmm.
And they took to their seats. And she's a middle school teacher. And she said that a flight attendant came over to check to see if her son was present before a standby passenger showed up with a ticket with the toddler's seat number.
Wait.
Okay, so this is what they do. This is what the airlines do.
Yeah.
They'll sell the tickets.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you could be sitting there and have your ticket in your seat, and a standby passenger will come up and have the same number as you.
What the heck?
And since you're there, technically that should be your seat, you know? And then they have to go back to the standby passenger and say, well, you bought one. See, because every flight that you have is overbooked. Every single one of them. But the problem is that the flight attendant came over to see if the kid was in the seat, right?
Yeah.
Because that's what she has to check. And so the middle school teacher said she told the flight attendant about the problem and said, hey, look, you know, my son, this is his seat. But the woman just shrugged and said the flight was full and walked away.
What the...
So, in other words, she had to hold her kid in her seat the entire time, even though she paid almost $1,000 for his seat.
So, she paid $1,000
to hold... Because a standby person, who probably paid half of that for their ticket, basically showed up. I'd have been like, look, man, here's the deal. Get off the plane because you're not taking my kid's seat.
Now, here's so this whole standby passenger thing has me, like, curious, because maybe it's been a while since I've been on a flight. How do I know if I'm a standby passenger or not?
Well,
when I go buy tickets,
because your ticket will, it should say standby on it. And when we buy, we don't, you know, no, we pay for it.
Really?
Okay. Yeah. And sort of a trick is that you buy your seat, and then when you go to pick it online or whatever, you do a little bit of an upgrade to get like more seat, and then they hopefully won't kick you.
Yeah.
I had a problem like this one time. We actually flew. I had both the daughters when they were young.
Yeah.
And they tried to separate us. Every flight we took, we made sure that we were all sitting together because they were real little. I mean, they were like 8 and 4, 3.
Yeah.
Something like that. They were pretty young. And when I get on the plane in Philly, I think it was, I get on the plane and we're all sitting in our seats. And a flight attendant came up and made my oldest daughter move so she could go sit somewhere else because a standby person had her seat number.
So?
And that's what I said. I'm like, hold on a second.
Yeah.
We have our tickets. We have our numbers. We're in the right seat. We're in the right assigned seat. These are my daughters. I'm flying with them. Well, he has this ticket, so we're going to go ahead and move your daughter over here.
This is, of course,
during the holidays.
Mm-hmm.
And I lost every bit of my cool because I'd been carrying a car seat and all sorts of crazy stuff trying to get through there. So I started getting really loud. And I can get really loud.
Yeah.
And the pilot actually... Because this is, you know, they let us board first because I had the car seat and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the pilot was cool about it and said, you know, come stand over here. And what they did was they went ahead and they pulled, you know, me and the kids aside out of our seats and they rearranged people so that we could sit together, even though we spent all that extra damn money to sit together in the first place.
Yeah.
Like, they were doing me a freaking favor. And this is why I hate airlines and flying.
Yeah.
They screw you and look you right in the face and go, well, this is just how it is. You have zero rights when you fly.
Then no more flying.
Well, you don't have a choice sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to do it. But they're shocked. The airlines are shocked when people don't want to fly, when people are unhappy, when they're not satisfied, and when they have issues like this. You know, if I paid $1,000 for a seat, my kid's in that seat.
Yeah.
And then at the very end of this article, right, and the flight attendant, of course, doesn't care.
Yeah.
She's like, oh, the flight's full, and just walked away. The company issued an apology 5 days later.
Yeah.
Oh, hell no. You're going to issue me $1,000.
You're going to, in 3 business days.
So, you know, it's like, hey, I got to pay all this damn money. No, I paid for a seat to sit on this flying tube of bacteria and filth with recycled air.
Yeah.
Being treated like cattle, you know, after being aggressively genital padded when you're there. What are you doing? Was the dog underneath my seat?
Yeah.
Yeah. Lots of thunder.
There's lots of thunder, so I put
it's
her
just
in
aggravating, you know. It's like, the flight was full.
Yeah.
I'm like, what? You know, you had a scorpion attack somebody. You beat up a businessman / doctor / whatever he was,
you
right?
Had two business people.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, come on, United. Yeah. You kind of suck a little bit. You know, he's like, okay, yeah. Well, guess what? I guess I'll keep flying American Airlines because United kind of sucks a little bit.
Yeah.
But I didn't hear anything about this, and this was July 6th, right? I mean, you think with, you know, United having issues that they were having, it something like this would show up.
God, that's so bad.
Yeah, and this is according to Boston.com. So, there you go, United. Good job.
Yeah, still blowing up the headlines.
Yeah. They were taking seats away from babies.
That would be a good headline.
That's what they are. It's like, yeah. United takes away baby seats. Makes them be stowed in the seat floor area in front of me. Because, you know, you can put, like, your bag up on the underneath the seat in front of you.
Yeah.
As long as it fits in that little spot.
Oh.
That's where you got to put your baby.
So I decided to type United Airlines into my news search.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And they're keeping up. It looks like every 2 days they're in the news.
Really?
Yeah. There's one little clickbaity one that I still like. It's 11 times United Airlines continue to make news in ways it probably regrets. And it's a full list.
Nice.
Yeah. And like overcharging, the doctor that was dragged off the flight.
Scorpion attack.
Apparently, Governor Chris Christie went off on a United Airlines tirade in two separate cable interviews. And then United fired back. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. The scorpion in the overhead bin. A giant pet rabbit was found dead.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So United basically, and they fired back against Governor Christie for having a little bit of a tirade.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they should probably get their shit together. I mean, seriously. I mean, I understand they're probably getting a little mad they're getting picked on, but if they really weren't sucking so bad.
They let a Boeing 787 with fuel pump pressure gauge deficiencies,
yeah,
operate for 23 domestic and international passenger flights.
Huh.
23. The thing was flying for 19 days before anybody even touched this massive repair. Yes.
Well, I mean, is it a massive repair?
Well, I mean, if it had gone out, apparently something would have happened.
I don't know.
Yeah. So.
See, I mean, a lot of, yeah. I mean, who knows?
They would have lost pressure, so.
I'm sure they had backups for that kind
of thing. Yeah. A wrecked wheelchair that was mangled during the flight. And it was one of those high-end, like, Stephen Hawking ones. It was a $55,000 wheelchair.
What?
It was a Stephen Hawking. Oh, and it, yeah, it was a Stephen Hawking level wheelchair. It's a, this person has spinal muscular atrophy.
Yeah.
Has a very high end wheelchair appraised at $55,509. And it was mangled somehow during the flight. They've provided him with a loaner wheelchair to use during his vacation.
Wow.
Oh my God. Yeah. This is a big, long, long list.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh.
Not good, United.
Yeah. And then the most recent one is that they're going to change their loyalty program so that it benefits nobody except for VIPs.
Really?
Yeah. It's about to get more difficult to use your loyalty program miles and loyalty program perks. Yeah.
They're just, you know, they're just embracing it.
Yes, this is, it's literally, it looks like every 2 days something has happened. And last week, an angry passenger posted thousands of United Airlines customer complaints online.
Really?
Yes. So, nice. Yes. I guess he has some sort of online account where he posted all of them. And United wants to take him to court.
Well, I think United's going to lose. So.
Yeah. That's just enough about United, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think we should change our title to United Still Sucks. I'm going to add it in there somewhere.
Yeah. But this thing that you found was pretty cool. If we keep on the whole theme of up in the air.
Yes.
Yes. You going to talk about this?
Maybe.
Okay.
What is it?
Amelia Earhart mystery may have.
Oh, yeah. We're going to talk about that after we take a break.
Yes.
Because I thought that was kind of cool. So I think we're going to do that real quick. We're going to go ahead and take a break. And you're listening to the Cheap Geek Podcast. We'll be right back with something that I thought was very interesting. Because this is kind of one of those unsolved mystery things that I've been watching since I was a little kid. Like last episode, we found that Roswell's been solved.
Okay.
Remember? I don't know if you remember. Do you remember?
Yeah.
We were here, right? You were here, mm-hmm. Roswell. So this time, it's the same thing. So we're going to take a little break and we'll be right back. Yeah.
Audible is audio entertainment that entertains, educates, and inspires. For you, the listeners of the Cheap Geek Podcast, Audible is offering a free audiobook download with a free 30-day trial to give you the opportunity to check out their services. We recommend for the podcast Neverwhere by Neil Gaiman, and since this is episode 42, we recommend Mostly Harmless by Douglas Adams. To download your free audiobook today, go to audibletrial.com/cheapgeek. Again, that's audibletrial.com/cheapgeek for your free audiobook. Enjoy this with your free trial, 30 days of membership free, plus 2 free audiobooks that are yours forever. 1 credit a month after trial, good for any book, regardless of price. Exclusive member savings. Get 30% off any additional audiobooks. Easy exchanges. Don't love a book? Swap it for free anytime, seriously.
And we're back. Check it out. So Amelia Earhart, right?
Yep.
Been missing for a very long time. No, seriously, like from the 40s, okay? She was a very modern woman in those times. Kind of a thrill seeker, you know?
Yeah.
She could do anything that men can do, that kind of thing. Was I don't want to say like women's liber, but she kind of showed it that she could do all that stuff. And so she was somebody to look up to, right?
Well, she was a modern feminist, if you think about it.
And you know, wore pants and all sorts of stuff like that. And she was a pilot. And she had a co-pilot. Mm-hmm. I'm actually a navigator. And they were going to... See, here's the thing. It's been so long. I'm not exactly sure what they were trying to do. I don't know if they were trying to fly around the world.
Fly solo across the Atlantic.
Ah, that's what it was.
Well, she was the first one to do that.
That's one of the things that she did. But she was trying to do something similar to that. and she pretty much went down somewhere, and they think that she went down in the Pacific Ocean.
Her goal was to circumnavigate a flight of the globe in like a continuous pattern. It's the same thing that What's-His-Face tried to do, Lindbergh, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah, but hers was a similar path that, you know, nobody had ever done.
Yeah, so this happened like 80 years ago. You know, there's been lots of theories to try to figure out what happened to her.
1937.
So, 37.
Yeah.
And so pretty much she went down, nobody knows where exactly, and there's always been sort of the theory that she's gone down in the Pacific, maybe around the Marshall Islands or somewhere like that, and they've been trying to kind of get an idea and find out, right? There's been all the researches and you know, showing up to examine some of these islands to try to find little parts and pieces and things like that.
Yeah.
You know, to kind of get an idea. And so they thought that they found parts of the plane, and there's all sorts of just theories going on. And so pretty much it started to become common knowledge, for the most part, if you followed any of this stuff, that she had gone down somewhere around the Marshall Islands. Or at least that's the thought.
Okay.
Or somewhere in a general area. Well, recently, and this is kind of a lead up to the History Channel is going to be having a show on this.
Okay.
They had a team of investigators from the History Channel, and they basically uncovered a never-before-seen photo. Right? And here's what they think. They believe that the photo actually shows Amelia Earhart and her navigator alive, but in Japanese custody after surviving a crash landing in the Pacific Ocean 80 years ago.
But no, I've heard about that photo before.
Where? Because this is news.
Yeah, no. It was like a conspiracy theorist brought it to everybody's attention a few years ago. I'm talking a while back. And nobody listened to him. He actually made it onto Coast to Coast.
Really?
Yeah, and nobody listened to him.
Well, maybe he's part of this investigatory team.
Yeah.
But yeah, some of these files were classified. And this came out of a classified file set. And the picture shows what appears to be her navigator and her sitting on this dock in the Marshall Islands, because it doesn't exactly say where.
Yeah.
So it's a picture that is reputed to be them.
Hmm.
And so they're trying to figure out, you know, what's going on. Because they still don't have any answers, though. So if the picture yields the photo itself, right?
Yeah.
Yields a new clue to this whole thing, and that she was taken into custody, in Japanese custody, what happened to her?
I don't know.
So one of the theories is that, well, she may have been brought into custody and then killed.
Yeah.
And, you know, after World War II and everything else, why wasn't there information released on this kind of thing? I mean, would you want to be known as, you know, somebody killed America's sweetheart? Because at the time, it was a pretty big deal.
Yeah.
And all the people that you would want to ask or could ask, that were on the Japanese side of things, they're all dead. Because this was like, what, 70 years ago, right?
Yeah.
80 years ago.
Well, maybe she became, if she was in Japanese custody, maybe she became Tokyo Rose or Axis what? Sally.
Why would she? No, I don't know. Those were Japanese. No.
I don't know.
Tokyo Rose, no.
I don't know.
That is ridiculous. No. But anyway, what it boils down to is that they still don't really know, but it does lend credence to the thing, to the idea that she went down around the Marshall Islands, and that's, you know, allegedly the Japanese got her.
Oh, wow. This History Channel thing, they're like breaking down the best they can the photo.
Absolutely. They took it to experts to be looked at. There's files and stuff to be. Because before, it was becoming accepted that, okay, the plane went down, and then that they survived on this uninhabited island and then died there.
Yeah. Died a horrible starving death.
Yeah. Well, they don't know. But they said, you know, died there. Because it possibly, you know, it could be, who knows? Because they said, you know, the malnutrition and stuff like that a little bit. But anyway, this is actually much worse. Because then it means that they were taken prisoner by the Japanese and then either killed or what? We don't know.
Yeah.
So, and in the picture, it even shows where they think it's her actual plane on a barge, and they took her. So, I don't know. And it kind of makes me want to watch the History Channel when this comes on because, you know, this was one of the shows I remember that when Leonard Nimoy or Nimoy did In Search Of, this was one of the ones I thought was really interesting.
Okay.
In Search Of Amelia Earhart, you know, because he did his little In Search Of show.
Yeah.
You ever seen that? It's pretty interesting. You see it on YouTube. But yeah, I seen that. I was like, no way. See, because Roswell, the possibility of human experimentation, right, which is horrible. And then here we go. Amelia Earhart and her navigator probably captured by the Japanese and then summarily executed for being spies.
That's
that's just as horrible, right? So, I mean, for the most part, it's kind of like some of these mysteries you think should just stay mysteries, and this may be one of them. Because she probably was killed to death by the Japanese.
That's terrible, though.
Yep. So.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure if she would have lived, she would have made some point to contact or try to contact if she was, you know, somehow would try to get it out there, you know?
Maybe on the Japanese radio.
No. Why would you? That's not even funny. That was propagandist. I mean, there was all sorts of stuff going on with that.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously.
No, I understand.
It was a terrible thing.
Yep.
So anyway, there's going to be a show. It's going to be on the History Channel, and you can watch it and hopefully see. Now, the people that are in the Marshall Islands, they think this is what happened anyway. They even had stamps made.
Oh.
Yeah. So.
Okay.
I mean, who knows? Yeah. But I think the guy you're talking about is this Gary Tarpinian.
Yeah.
That's the dude with the picture.
I know, because I remember hearing about it. It was years ago. Someone literally called Coast to Coast and claimed they had, like, photo evidence.
I don't know.
So, yeah. I don't know.
Crazy. But, anyway, I thought it was kind of neat. It's like, what? But sadly, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Especially with the picture. You know, because when I first seen the picture, it's really hard to tell. But then they kind of break it down. You're like, you know, I guess this could be her.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's all I got to say about that.
Well, yeah. For other weird stuff, we do have a whole New Mexico or Florida section. We actually have three different ones today. So, I'll go ahead. Yeah, these are a little unbelievable. I'll read.
You know,
off.
Hold on. Yeah. You know what's? We're sitting here. It's storming outside, and it's usually so dry all the time.
Yeah.
That when humidity rolls in here and the pressure change is like for a storm, it gives me a huge headache.
Yeah.
This means I'm old and I suck. That's what that means.
Well, like some
speaking
old
of sucks,
people, let's be enraged by the news. And
all right, here we go.
And play New Mexico or Florida.
All right.
I'll start. Woman arrested after waving gun at Dunkin' Donuts customers. New Mexico or Florida?
Well, that's definitely New Mexico.
Darn it. You're right. Yeah. So, this was actually...
hold on. So, here's what happened,
yeah.
Right? So, Rita Howling Crane...
Yes.
...had asked a security guard in the area to buy her food from Dunkin' Donuts.
Uh-huh.
Right? That's what police say.
Yeah.
So, after entering, she reportedly became agitated at other customers.
Yeah.
She left the coffee shop, came back with her gun... And started pointing it at him.
Yes.
So then the security guard pulled his gun on her and then told the customers in the shop to take cover. So then the police say that Howling Crane responded by throwing her gun in a dumpster outside and sitting in the parking lot before police arrived.
With the security guard keeping his firearm trained on her.
Yeah.
Oh, the gun was stolen, of course.
Yeah, and yes. She's a felon.
Yeah.
So it's a felon in possession of a firearm and receiving a stolen firearm.
So the way I'm reading this, though, it looks like she asked, maybe she was busy at work or something, so she asked the security guard to get her food. It took too long. There were too many customers in there, so her solution was to scare all the customers out by waving a gun at them.
Yeah. I mean, that makes sense, right?
Yeah. Oh, that totally makes sense.
Yeah. It's like, I want my donuts, and you guys are taking too damn long.
I mean,
which kind of makes sense, because in New Mexico, it can take a while to do most everything. A whole manana time?
Yeah,
I can see it's like, come on, man. I don't have time for you guys to be standing around trying
to figure
it out.
I mean, when we first got here, we did that story about the pregnant woman and the man getting into a brawl at a Dairy Queen.
Yep.
With the Dairy Queen employees.
Yep. Everybody's fighting.
Yeah. Fighting over a blizzard. And now this. I mean... my blood sugar was low. That's probably what she's going to tell the cops.
Yeah,
my blood sugar
cool
was low.
Howling Crane.
Yeah, that's pretty kicking.
So there's an old priest arrested in road rage incident after pulling out a gun.
Okay.
A priest.
So we have a lot of priests and we have a lot of road rage in New Mexico. So I'm going to say New Mexico.
Nope. This one's Florida.
Really?
So yeah, it's a North Carolina priest.
Okay.
And old William Adams, right, was arrested in connection with a road rage incident in on the Florida Turnpike, right, near Palm City.
Yeah.
So evidently pulled a gun out. And I don't really know anything more than that, except for he was driving a...
Oh, he tried to
He was driving a red Chevy Corvette.
Yeah.
When he attempted to brake check another vehicle, which was a Chevy Silverado pickup truck, right?
So we have two Chevys involved.
Too closely, right?
Yeah.
And as the victim attempted to pass the Corvette, the driver pointed a semi-automatic handgun at him. So basically he was like, you know, you're getting too close, and then tried to brake check him. When they passed him, he pointed the gun at him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. And he had posted a tweet about it. And that tweet has been taken down.
Well, I would hope so.
But so far, it looks like everybody's been arrested, and the Glock 22 has been taken to the sheriff's office.
It's a Glock 22. Nice.
Yeah.
So, you know, when I hear priest, I don't normally think of priest driving little red Corvettes and brandishing weapons at people.
No, I don't. So, I don't. And plus, the article was written really confusing. When I was trying to do some research when I first read this, I actually thought, wait, who's being... There's like three different articles. One says the priest did it. The other says that the other guy pulled the gun. The other says that there was almost a fight that ensued. So I don't really know what's going on, but don't be a jerk. There's no reason to pull out a gun over road rage and stupid stuff.
That's what people do.
I know.
But, you know, I kind of would expect more from a priest, I guess. I don't know.
Me too.
Kind of strange.
Well, you know, red Corvette, so.
Yeah. He's, you know, 35, maybe going through a little midlife crisis or something.
But he's a priest. Midlife crisis happened.
Hey, man, I don't know.
Middle-aged married people.
I don't think so. I think it can happen whenever. I think it can strike at any time.
Okay. Well,
yeah, next thing you know, you're buying a Corvette, cruising down a Florida freeway. Hanging out, somebody gets too close in their Chevy Silverado.
Yeah.
And you're like, you're not going to pass me. I'll show you my weapon. Yeah.
Well, this guy would not be able to see a weapon, much less anything else. Florida or New Mexico, blind man sues NBA team because he can't watch the games.
What?
Yeah.
I don't know. Florida?
Actually, you would be right. Blind man is currently suing the Miami Heat, claims he's not able to go and watch the games. Yes.
So what's he? I guess I don't understand.
Neither do I. Andreas Gomez claims the Heat, the American Airlines Arena, and their website are in violation of the Americans with Disabilities Act. And is planning to take the Miami Heat to federal court. Gomez says that he was unable to go watch games and concerts, and as a result, suffered particularized harm and injury in fact.
What?
Yeah. So, the problem with this is he's blind. He is almost completely blind. He does use special software that allows him to read websites, but it doesn't work on the arena's website where you can buy tickets. So because his software doesn't work on the website, he can't buy tickets, and he can't somehow buy tickets at the stadium either. So because of that, he's not allowed to watch games, and they are discriminating against him.
Yeah.
If I were blind, I would probably call and purchase tickets. But my thing is, I probably wouldn't go to a basketball
game. It goes back to the whole inconvenience thing.
I know, but still... If I can't see well enough to read my laptop or read a book or look at this water bottle in front of me, I don't think I'm going to go see a basketball game. or watch a basketball game.
Listen to a basketball game.
It's all the same thing. Lots of cheerleaders shouting and basketball bouncing.
Because see, here's something too. I mean, I get going to see it if that's what you want to do.
Yeah.
But, you know, a lot of times these games are actually on the radio.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I wonder if this is just an attempt to get money.
Yeah.
You know, like how many, I wish they had more information, like, you know, he goes to lots of games or something, but I don't.
So, I've worked with people with visual limitations. One of my last jobs I did. And, you know, they have special software. The software reads websites. It reads, you know, applications they need to use to do their job. And that's great and all. So if your website isn't in compliance with the ADA, the American Disabilities Act, yes, you are at fault. But I don't see how that goes straight from, oh, my God, I can't use this website, to immediately filing a suit.
I don't know.
Instead of, you know, maybe contacting the webmaster or calling customer service. Yeah. This whole article reads like it's immediate.
Yeah. Grabbing some monies.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I agree. It's an ADA violation, but I still question the whole, I don't understand why he'd buy tickets. So, yeah, right there in Florida. So, that's about it.
That's not it, man.
I know.
Really?
So,
okay.
What else we have going on now?
I'm still just... people amaze me.
Yeah?
That's all I got to say about that. So, anyway, what it boils down to is that we have a bunch of stuff that we actually have talked about. Yeah. All of it somewhat uninteresting, but will become interesting. As in, Rob Lowe, you have to wait until August to figure out if you actually seen a wood ape or not.
Yeah.
Right? NASA's not having a child slave colony on Mars. I'm pretty sure that's not true. It'll probably take decades before we figure out if that's going to happen.
Yeah.
All of our mountains are on fire.
Yeah.
Right? United still sucks. So it's probably going to take them a long time before they actually get all fixed up, you know.
Yeah.
And maybe be fixing some stuff. An 80-year-old mystery may have been solved with Amelia Earhart in that picture. Would like to have some kind of closure to it, just to kind of see. I would like to think that she wasn't captured and executed by the Japanese.
Yep.
But who knows? People suing because, you know, you can't see basketball games. You know, people brandishing weapons at Dunkin' Donuts. What's going on, man? It's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
A priest in his little red Corvette trying to be Mr. Tough Guy. And he was from Carolina, too. He was incensed that Silverado was trying to take over and overtake his vet. I don't know.
Yeah.
So it's actually kind of sad. We haven't even really seen very much. We haven't really had very good TV experiences, though. We really don't have anything for Bingeworthy BS, do we?
Not really.
Because we're still waiting for the new seasons to start. So if you listen to this podcast, chances are by the time you listen to it, you'll know that Game of Thrones is coming back on.
We
don't watch Game of Thrones. Yeah.
We decided to get caught up on Criminal Minds, and while we were doing that, we did realize there's been some drama with the cast, like, internally. Ooh. So that's bothered us, and now we're looking forward to the next season. We're going to see where that leaves the current cast.
Yeah.
Otherwise, in my opinion, Criminal Minds is starting to jump the shark. We got all caught up.
I think it's been kind of jumped it a while ago, but you know.
Well, I mean, not to the extreme of like Law and Order, you know, but
oh wow, yeah,
yeah. But we did get caught up on that. We are currently trying to binge on NCIS, but honestly, it just not much has been on.
Nope.
We used to be really devoted to The Voice and America's Got Talent. But the past two seasons, for me, have just been, I would rather read or look up weird news for the podcast, honestly.
Yeah.
You know? So, it's been a pretty slow summer. Also, because of my new job, I've been working events and stuff like that. So, by the time I get home, it's mostly eat dinner, read the funny news, pet the dogs. So, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. That's why I am kind of looking forward to a couple of days off, checking out maybe some new movies that you can rent on Prime Day.
Yeah.
For, you know, like 99 cents. And I don't know. Just hopefully we can go a couple of places over the next couple of weeks, share those on our social media, take some pictures of the dogs, because we know you guys like the dogs. Speaking of which, Ben and Pepper are still in a photo contest.
You can vote.
Yes. You can vote once a day, so make sure you do that.
We have a link.
Yeah.
So you can go to the link and click and vote.
Yes. Vote for my brave puppers, please.
Yeah. For the 7 people that listen to this podcast, your vote
is appreciated.
Yeah. But yeah.
So.
Yeah.
But that's pretty much it, guys.
Yep, not a whole lot going on. We've been kind of working, been kind of doing our thing. It's storming. Hopefully it'll rain and put out some of the fires because everything's been on fire. It's been pretty good, though. So we'll be coming back with a podcast in the next couple days or so. We'll have some updates and stuff like that.
Cool.
So we've been kind of looking at when's the best time to publish this podcast. We kind of go back and forth between Wednesdays and Sundays. So we have to revisit that because we actually have, believe it or not, a bunch of new listeners. And our data is a little askew. Do you know that? I've been looking into the metrics of things and trying to find the best day. Doesn't apply anymore. Actually, we have to kind of take a deeper look.
Okay.
What that means is we have more people listening to the podcast, and for that, we are very much appreciative. So, like I said, you can listen to us on iTunes and Google Play Music and the website and Facebook. You can join the CheapGeek Facebook group and all those wonderful places that you can actually kind of... did I say SoundCloud? No. Did I say iHeartRadio? No, but you can get us there.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's really about all I got. So, if you like the music in this podcast, the music you can go to incompetech.com. It's Kevin McLeod's music, and if you do a Creative Commons attribution, you can use it too. Anyway, it's a 3.0, which is pretty nice. This guy makes amazing music and lets everybody use it. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
So, but yeah, anyway, that's about all I got. You got anything?
Nope.
All right. Anyway, see you later. Take it easy. Bye-bye.
Bye.
I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, peanut butter, I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, peanut butter, I like peanut butter.